And remember, life is too short to be drinking shitty beer.
It's... Put it this way, they've got a stupid rule there. Okay? The brewer cannot deliver to the retailer direct. Now, I heard this before as well. I went to a little craft pub in Chicago, just outside Chicago, in a place called Edison. It's called Bigsby's Poorhouse. If you're ever out that way, get in there. The owner is a fantastic bloke. He's a Filipino bloke. He was only 29 at the time, and he owned two. And he was so... Listening to him talk about beer, it was just brilliant. But he was saying the same thing, you know, the hoops he has to jump through just to sell his own craft beer and other people's craft beer. It's just, you know, they talk about the land of the free and all that. But when it comes to alcohol, I mean, for fuck's sake, you can't buy a beer until you're 21 in America. You can go out and join the army and, you know, blow people up when you're 18. You can't buy a beer until you're 21. Fuck off. Fuck off. Anyway, calm down, Bern. So listen, let's get back to the beer. Just the beer, not the corporations, okay? I'm going to review them together, but I'm just going to go over what's going on with this one, right? This is 5% of the volume. Ingredients, water, barley, malt, hops, and that's it. Nothing else. This is actually brewed to the 1516 purity law, the German Reinheitsgebot. If that's how it's pronounced. But if you look at the back, it says produced in the finest Saaz aroma hops, carefully selected Moravian malt, and soft water drawn from wells 300 metres deep. Yeah, they're artisan wells. If you're not familiar with what artisan wells are, they're basically, it's trapped water that's under pressure, and they drill down, and the pressure releases the water. And it's great because it's covered in all these minerals and whatnot, and it does flavour the water in a good way. It's like it seasons it. The 700 years of brewing tradition, 700, so yeah, that is longer than even I said, of tradition guarantees the best quality of Budweiser beer. And it's imported. This is imported, so it's still brewed and bottled by Budvar. I'm not even going to pronounce this, but it's still brewed and exported from the Czech Republic. Brilliant. Okay. And of course, as I said, you've got all the history and the heritage behind it. And yeah, Czech imported lager. Nice bottle, red and white label. Very Czech in its look. Okay, let's have a look at this one. This is a 660 milliliter bottle. I couldn't get anything smaller. I wanted to get a smaller bottle. This was the only one they had, so I've had to bite the bullet. It's 4.5% in volume. This is the king of beers, apparently. The king of beers. That's a fucking bold claim, that is, to be the king of beers. And do you know what? They even stole that from Budvar. Budvar's sort of motto, sort of sales thing, was the beer of kings. What did they do? They reduced it and said the king of beers. This is the king of beers. Did you know? I didn't fucking know that. That's a fucking bold claim. The king of beers. Yeah. So what's it got? Water, barley, malt, rice and hops. Rice. Not just any old rice. Genetically modified rice. That's what you've got in there. You've also got purified water. It's not drawn from wells 300 feet down, right? It's purified. And it's and they use in the process, they use, I think it's barrels made out of beech wood, right? Even them barrels and any wood that's involved in the brewing process is boiled in bicarbonate of soda for an hour to remove any hint of flavour. It's like they don't want any flavour in this beer. I know I'm going into one, but fuck it, they deserve it. Because people buy this shit. I work with a bloke, and he buys it, he thinks it's great. And I just think, well, you know, why not live on boiled rice? Genetically modified boiled rice. But yeah, and that's it, that's all I can say. Budweiser, king of beers, brewed by original process from the choicest hops. Original process, did that involve boiling up all the wood in bicarbonate of soda? Fucking bollocks. Yeah, and they got all the markings filled. I don't even want to read it because I'm going to go into a rant. And calm down. So let's open them up. Right. First of all, I'll open this one up and I've got a bit of a funny story with this one. It's got a twist off cap. This is not new, right? They've had twist off caps for years, right? And I used to open bottles with my teeth. I don't now because I fucking lost a tooth. I lost a couple of teeth from doing it. I wouldn't recommend that, but I've done it for years. It wasn't a party trick. It was just handy. You know, I didn't have a bottle opener on me. People, you know, you'd be out buying a bottle of beer. Oh, I ain't got a bottle opener. Give it here. Crack. There you go. It was great. I don't do it no more. But I got a twist off cap. And back in the day when I was opening with my teeth, I remember going on holiday to Crete with my ex and a few of her mates and a few of my mates. It was a mental holiday. And we was in the bar. And I was drinking Bitburger. German Bitburger. It's a lovely beer. But they ran out. And he'd give me a bottle of this. And I kept opening them with my teeth. And I was drinking more and more. And he went, oi, mate. He said, screw off cap. I was like, oh, for fuck's sake. So I've been opening screw off caps with my teeth. Yeah, so no wonder I've lost a tooth. But anyway, screw off cap. So let's open it up. Right, there's a bit of smoke there. Bit of lemon. And nothing. At least they put it in a brown bottle so it doesn't react with the light. That's good. That's a plus for Budweiser. Because if you put beer in clear glasses, it can react with the light. The hops can react with the light. Mind you, I'm not sure what sort of hops they've got in here. But I'm pouring it out now. Look at that. Can you hear that carbonation? Listen to it. It's like champagne. And it's clear. That is clear. Uncontaminated with anything, including flavour. Very hard to get anything out of that at all. I'm getting faint lemon, bit of citrus, slight lager malts, but not a lot else. I'm just going to let that head settle down there because it's frothing away a lot of good, and I'll pour the rest of it in there. Right, so that's that. I'm going to put this bottle down here. I'll probably be picking it up in a bit. Now let's open this one up. This is the traditional cap off with the bottle opener. Got the K-bar bottle opener. I'm going to open that up. Oh, immediately. Strong hoppy. Sales hops. Yeah, strong hoppy aroma. So immediately there's character there. A slight lemony citrus flavour to it too. Or flavour, aroma. Got to stop doing that. Here we go. Let's pull this one out. Lively too. But not half as gassy. Yeah, and it really does. It smells. You can smell them hops in it for starters, and it gives it a lot of character. Now, look, let's just compare the two. You see them two different colours?